Odds of a second stimulus check have been volatile, peaking in late July when the Republican-led Senate passed the HEALS Act. At that point, Democrats, Republicans, and the White House were all in support of a second stimulus check. However, it has yet to materialize because of an extended impasse in negotiations over other issues like extended federal unemployment benefits and aid to state and local governments. Results from a poll conducted in early August for the Franklin Templeton-Gallup Economics of Recovery Study point to overwhelming support for a second stimulus payment. The findings make it even more shocking that a proposal in an election year, in the middle of a pandemic, and with strong bipartisan support still hasn't been able to pass in Washington. Overall, 7 in 10 Americans surveyed support the government sending a second economic impact payment (EIP), more commonly known as a second stimulus check, to all qualifying adults. More interestingly, despite deep polarization on a number of policies related to COVID-19, an additional EIP receives strong support among both Democrats and Republicans, Gallup noted. 82% of Democrats supported an additional payment, but so did 64% of Republicans and 66% of Independents. Gallup asked individuals who supported giving a second payment about what the maximum amount should be among ranges, from less than $300 to $900 or more. 66% supported a maximum payment of $900 or more. There was less variability by political affiliation on the maximum amount of the payment, with 68% of Democrats and 60% of Republicans indicated they preferred a high payout. Interestingly, there was higher variation in age ranges, with older supporters more likely to advocate for a high payment than younger ones. 75% of the over 65-year-old age group supported a $900 or more payment, while only 42% of the 18 to 34-year-old cohort. The Gallup poll helps reinforce that there is strong demand for additional stimulus relief. However, the poll is less insightful than it could have been due to a strange design choice. Specifically, it is unclear why Gallup chose to ask respondents about maximum payment amounts and have the highest category only be $900 or more. The CARES Act passed in March included an initial round of $1,200 payments. The HEROES Act passed by the House included a second stimulus check of $1,200. The HEALS Act proposed by the Senate included a $1,200 second stimulus check. Notice a pattern? Given that $1,200 has been the focal point in all bills, it's unclear why Gallup didn't choose amounts on either side of that figure. It would have been more informative to have used other amounts and teased out support for payment amounts less than, but also greater than $1,200. Perhaps there would be interesting insights on a partisan divide for higher dollar amounts? Sadly, the Gallup poll didn't address this.